This is a brief introduction to URSA's Time Series tool. From the main URSA homepage, if you go to the WISE page and scroll down, under URSA Services, you can find a link to the Time Series tool. Load the tool, and you can see that you can upload a file from disk. I already have a file ready to go, and it is a WISE table. Upload. In the upper left here is a control panel. It reminds me what file I uploaded. It made a guess as to what time column I wanted, MJD, and what value I wanted to plot, in this case, the WISE-1 photometry. The images information here describes these images down here. Right now, they're displaying the WISE-1 images, but I could also ask it to display WISE-2, WISE-3, or WISE-4, and I can change the cutout size. Let's go back to WISE-1. Here's the input data table that I uploaded. Just as for any other URSA tables that have this look and feel, if I click in the table, other things change. The images are linked to the table. So any row that I click on in the table is shown as the image cutout in the middle. Because the table is sorted by time, this is the epoch before the highlighted epoch, this is two epochs back, this is the epoch after, and this is two epochs ahead. It also plots the light curve here, and this is interlinked too. If I click here, then the images change and the table changes. What I would like to do is find if there's a period in this light curve. If I go to Period Finder, then I get launched into a different screen. It takes the time and the value that I set on the previous page. I can enter a period manually, I can use the slider to pick a period, or I can calculate the periodogram. I would like to calculate the periodogram. It comes up by default with a lot of blanks. You'll just have to trust that the defaults are actually pretty good and you can just leave the fields blank. Exactly how it sets those defaults is described in the documentation, which can be obtained from the Help tab. Let's calculate. So it returns the periodogram in this table and a plot here. It also gives us the peaks and a plot of power versus peak number here. Let's go back to the periodogram. The peak value that it has is here. So if I click that peak, it will phase the light curve using that period. I can choose one of the other peaks, and if I do, I decide that really that's the best period to use. I can use the slider to investigate small changes in the period, but I kind of like this period, so I'm going to accept that period. Now we're back in the main screen, and now we have another tab here. This tab, instead of being the light curve as a function of time, now is the phase folded data. So it's got a phase column, and the data table is sorted by that phase. So now, if I click on a row in the table or a point in the plot, the images update according to this sorting. So this is not the previous epoch. This is the previous closest point in phase, and two steps back, and likewise for the next one and two steps forward. To save these results, I can either copy and paste the period into a file that I'm keeping elsewhere. If I want to save individual images, I can click to highlight the image and then click on the diskette icon to save that. I can save the table of phase folded data. This is the input table I uploaded, so I probably already have a copy of that. If I click on here, it selects every object in the table, and if I click on prepare download, it will download all of the cutouts for all of the epochs in this table. Needless to say, if you have a very long light curve, it may take a long time to package up all of those epochs. Believe it or not, the best way to save the plot at this point is to do a screen snapshot. Another interesting thing you can do is if you want to take, say, the WISE-2 magnitudes and phase it using the same period that I determined from the WISE-1 magnitudes, this is what I've done here. I've changed the column that it's plotting, but it's still using the period from before. So this is now WISE-2 folded to the period determined from WISE-1. There are a few more videos that cover how to deal with common problems.